Hello dear students, today we are going to study two important theorems in rotational dynamics. First one is theorem of perpendicular axis and second one is theorem of parallel axis. These two theorems are very important theorems regarding NEET, JEE as well as CET exam. Okay? Students, we have already discussed the concept of moment of inertia. In last two lectures, we studied this concept of moment of inertia. And in that concept, we have already studied that moment of inertia of any rigid body, moment of inertia of any rigid body along the given axis of rotation is always constant. And this moment of inertia of a rigid body along the given axis of rotation depends on three factors. First one is mass, shape, size of that body. First one is mass, shape and size of the body. Second one is position of this axis of rotation. Second one is position of the axis of rotation. And third one is distribution of mass along the given axis of rotation. It clearly indicates that the moment of inertia of any rigid body along the given axis of rotation is always constant. But if we change axis of rotation, moment of inertia of the rigid body also changes. If we change the axis of rotation of a rigid body, then moment of inertia of that body also changes. And if we know moment of inertia about one axis, we can determine moment of inertia about another axis. If we know moment of inertia of a rigid body about one axis, we can determine its moment of inertia about another axis. And for this purpose, two important theorems are used. First important theorem used for this purpose is theorem of perpendicular axis. Let us study first of all theorem of perpendicular axis, and then we study theorem of parallel axis. Theorem of perpendicular axis. Suppose this is a plane laminar body. This is a plane laminar body. Plane laminar body means body having very small thickness. Suppose this is a plane paper. We can say that it is a plane laminar body. And this theorem of perpendicular axis is used to determine the moment of inertia of a laminar body. Okay? This is a plane laminar body. Suppose that this axis Z passing through point O of the lamina, and this axis Z is perpendicular to the plane of lamina. Axis Z passing through point O of the lamina, and it is perpendicular to the plane of lamina. Okay? Consider two mutually perpendicular axes, axis X and axis Y. These two axes, that is axis X and axis Y, are lying in the plane of lamina. These axis X and Y lies in the plane of lamina. Axis Z is perpendicular to the plane of lamina. But this axis X and Y lies in the plane of lamina. These two axes, X and Y, are mutually perpendicular to each other, but they are lying in the plane of lamina. And these two axes, X and Y, intersect at a point where this perpendicular axis cuts the lamina. Okay? Axis X and axis Y intersect at a point O where perpendicular axis Z cuts that lamina. Okay? Then, according to the principle of perpendicular axis, we can write Iz equals to Ix plus Iy, where Ix is moment of inertia of a plane lamina above x axis. Iy is the moment of inertia of the plane lamina above y axis. at I z, if the moment of inertia of a plane laminar about z axis, then according to principle of perpendicular axis, according to theorem of perpendicular axis, we can write I z is equal to I x plus I y. And from this equation, we can state this theorem of perpendicular axis. This perpendicular axis theorem states that moment of inertia of a plane laminar about an axis perpendicular to its plane is equal to sum of its moment of inertia about two mutually perpendicular axes lying in the plane of lamina and intersect at a point where perpendicular axes cut the lamina. Theorem of perpendicular axis states that moment of inertia of a plane lamina about an axis perpendicular to its plane is equal to sum of its moment of inertia about two mutually perpendicular axes lying in the plane of lamina and intersect at a point where perpendicular axis cuts the lamina. This is the statement for perpendicular axis. Now we are going to prove this principle of perpendicular axis. Proof of theorem of perpendicular axis. In order to prove this theorem of perpendicular axis, let us consider a small element of that lamina at point P. Suppose that dm is the mass of single element of the lamina. Dm is mass of single element which is situated at point P. And we know that element is nothing but infinitesimal, very very small part of the body. Okay? Draw perpendicular Pm and Pn. Perpendicular Pn on x axis, perpendicular Pn on y axis. Join OP. Then this distance OM represent x coordinate of the element PM. And this distance OM represent y coordinate of the element DM. OM represent x coordinate of element DM. OM represent y coordinate of element DM. Okay? This distance OM x, therefore distance NP is also x, parallel sides. This distance MP is also y because OM is y. Therefore, we can say that this element BM is at a distance y from x axis. Element BM is at a distance y from x axis and this element BM is at a distance x from y axis. Now, the moment of inertia of this element DM, moment of inertia of element DM about x axis is y square DM. Moment of inertia of element dm about x axis is y square into dm. And we know that this plane lamina made up of number of such elements. And by indicating moment of inertia of a single element, we can determine moment of inertia of a whole lamina about x axis. That is, Ix, moment of inertia of a whole lamina about x axis is integration of y square into dm. Suppose this is equation number 1. Similarly, this element dm is at a distance x from y axis. What is moment of inertia of element dm about y axis? X square dm. X square dm is moment of inertia of element dm about y axis. X square into dm. And there are number of such small elements. This plane lamina consists of number of such elements. Therefore, by integrating moment of inertia of a single element, we can get moment of inertia of a whole lamina about y axis. That is, moment of inertia of this plane lamina about y axis is I y is equal to integration of x square into dm. Suppose this is equation. Similarly, this element dm is at a distance OP, at a distance OP from z axis. Element dm is at a distance OP from z axis. Moment of inertia of this element dm about z axis, which is perpendicular to plane, inertia of a whole lamina about z axis. That is, Iz equal to integration of op square dm. Suppose this is equation number 3. Ix, moment of inertia of a plane lamina about x axis, which is equal to integration of y square into dm. Iy is moment of inertia of a plane lamina about y axis, which is equal to integration of x square into dm. Iz is the moment of inertia of this plane lamina about z axis, which is equal to integration of op square into dm. But from here, this op square is nothing but this, consider this triangle OMP. Consider this triangle OMP. We can write op square equal to y square plus x square. Op square equal to y square plus x square. Op square equal to y square plus x square. Okay? Therefore, equation 3 becomes Iz equal to integration of op square is y square plus x square into dm. We can separate this integration as integration of y square dm plus integration of x square dm. From equation number 1, integration of y square dm is nothing but ix, and integration of x square dm is nothing but iy, and therefore we can write Iz equal to ix plus iy. Very important equation. This is the equation of perpendicular axis. From this equation, it is clear that moment of inertia of a plane lamina about an axis perpendicular to its plane is equal to sum of its moment of inertia about two mutually perpendicular axes lying in the plane of lamina and intersect at a point where perpendicular axis cuts the lamina. This is the theorem of perpendicular axis. Okay?